بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome to a new episode where we are discussing the process that we need to implement in order to understand Islam correctly. And we said that this process is a very simple process that every single one of you will be able to use to understand Islam generally speaking, not necessarily to extract ruling mujtahid, but to understand Islam and to navigate through these different fatawas, through those different ideologies that every single one of us is aware of. Last time we started to speak about one important a principle that we need to employ on Quran and Sunnah in order to understand them correctly. And this principle is we need to look at the Quran and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as one body, and we cannot isolate one single verse in isolation from the rest of the body of the Quran and the Sunnah. We cannot single out one hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and leave the other ahadith or the other verses of the Quran and Sunnah. We said that this is one of the pitfalls of some of the sects, one of the main mistakes of some of the sects who introduced many bid'at in al-Islam. Take this example. There is a sect that says, if a Muslim says, La ilaha illallah, this will be more than enough for him to get into Jannah and not to be punished in the fire of hell. And hence, there is no need for us as Muslims to do or to practice Islam, to put Islam into practice. There is no need for us to pray five times. There is no need for us to fast. There is no need for us to be truthful in our speech, to be kind to our parents, etc. As far as the Muslim knows that Allah is the only God, and he says, La ilaha illallah, this will be enough for him to be saved from the punishment of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Subhanallah. Where did they come up with this idea? The source of this idea is the mistake that they made in understanding Islam. And they just took one single hadith and they thought that this hadith is more than enough to understand the concept regarding entering Jannah and Nar. And they said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever says La ilaha illallah, dakhal al-Jannah. And this is a hadith that has been reported in Sahih Muslim and many other books. It is true that this is a hadith that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam said that the fornicator does not fornicate while he is a mu'min. It is true that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that he saw Muslims being punished in the hellfire. Muslims being punished in the fire of hell. The fornicator, the one who deals in riba, the one who backbites and other people. So how come from one hand, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever says La ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah means he will not go to fire of hell. And on the other hand, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam approved that there are many Muslims who say La ilaha illallah, yet they will be punished. See, we have to understand both arguments. We have to look at both sides of a hadith. We cannot just rely on one single hadith or one single verse and make it the only hadith that judges the whole concept of al-Islam. You can see how many people can go wrong in understanding al-Quran and the Sunnah. Of course, this is a very important and practical principle that can be implemented in various ways, and it is very, very useful. I cannot dwell into this concept more because of time limitations. However, I would like just to say in summary, the second main concept or the second main step that we need to implement in order to understand the textual evidences includes number of principles. The first one, we need to employ the consensus of scholars to understand Quran and Sunnah. We also can use qiyas, which is extending the ruling by analogy, in order to use Quran and Sunnah to expand, or in order to use them to cover new cases and to expand the application of Quran and Sunnah. Then we said we need to understand Quran and Sunnah according to the dictates of the Arabic language. And we also introduced a very important concept, which is what? We need to look at the whole body of Quran and Sunnah. We need to look at them all at once. So these are the main tools that constitute the second step of understanding Quran and Sunnah. I hope that the matter is clear for everyone. Now let us move to the third step, which is what? The implementation of what we understood. What do we mean by the implementation of what we understood? I will recall the example that I have mentioned before, and that's why I will not dwell into this step, because I already explained it. This step says that you, after getting the source, after understanding it correctly, you need to implement it correctly, because the meaning is something and the application of the meaning is something else. You remember what we said about a person who wants to drive a car, who is studying how to drive a car. He understood how to drive a car well, but when we put him to drive the car actually in front of the steering, he wouldn't be able to implement what he learned from Quran and Sunnah. This is one thing. The other thing, do you remember the scenario of Brother Samir and his wife Samira, who wanted to buy meat from the supermarket, and they differed whether this meat is halal or haram, and she quoted the ayah from the Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala made حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتَ, Allah Jalla wa Ala made the mayta as haram, and he said, no, I disagree with you that this ayah, which we confirmed its meaning, can be implemented on this case. I'll give you another example. Many people are talking about political participation, and many people say that according to Islam, we must rule by the law of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And we said yes. And they said that if you rule by any law other than the law of Allah Jalla wa Ala, this is an act of kufr, which is true. But some people, when they come to the issue of political participation or voting, they say that voting is not allowed because it means that you accepted to rule by other than the rule of Allah Jalla wa Ala, and Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ, and you are giving your vote for those who rule by other than the rule of Allah Jalla wa Ala. We said that the ayah is, of course, is authentic. No one can dispute about the authenticity of the Quran. And the meaning of the ayah, which is anyone who rules by any rule other than the rule of Allah Jalla wa Ala, they are indeed the kafirun. This is the meaning in general. But how to apply this meaning on particular cases, it is a matter of discussion. Many people do not understand that there are certain steps, and they think that if there is a ruling, then we just, if there is a verse, we can apply it immediately. My dear respected brothers and sisters, the topic is huge, but alhamdulillah, I managed to give the summary of this important process in a very summarized, concise way, so every single one of you can use that process to understand the basics of Al-Islam, at least to understand what is going on. And as I said, it is the obligation, the Islamic obligation, that every one of us should strive his best or her best in order to understand Islam as Allah Jalla wa Ala wants. We put a lot of effort in understanding other things, but we do not put enough effort to understand Islam. Please, my dear respected brothers and sisters, as I am concluding this series, I would like every single one of you to remember that the real process, the correct process to understand Islam includes three main steps. Get the correct sources of Al-Islam, Quran, Sunnah, Ijma' and Qiyas. Understand them correctly and then implement them correctly. Try it in a very basic format and you will see the beauty of Al-Islam. You will see the beauty of knowledge. جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم for good listening to this series. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.